guys, Kandi Blaze here with Kandi's Rods and Customs at 1722 Claremont Avenue in the beautiful heart of downtown Ashland, Ohio. Oh my gosh, there is so much beauty around me right now, guys. Okay, so 41 Ford, 32.5 window coupe, 1970 Atomic Fireball Nova, myself and Rob McCrae's. Okay, guys. I think we're all still really tired, and we're probably still running on adrenaline from this past weekend. So where were we? I know you guys were following the pictures. We were up in Pontiac, Michigan, at Roadkill Nights. Oh my gosh. So we were part of the Tom Bailey Racing Woodward Pre-Party, also hosted up by RPM Magazine, and it was held at Roadkill. Now technically it was held at Lapeer International Dragway too, but even though the team was working as hard as we possibly could, we were up till like 2 a.m. more than one night working on the Nova. And well, by the time Thursday rolled around, we were in here, most of us, is 6 o'clock in the morning. And we didn't get up until, up in the area of Pontiac up until almost 7 in the evening. That's how hard we were working. So we didn't make it to Lapeer, but we did make it to Roadkill, and we had a blast. So let's talk about the Atomic Fireball right here, guys. Now, she's still a little bit under construction like she was up at Roadkill. Well, what's that mean? Well, you see, not all the trim work's still on her, and there's a reason why. Okay, so let's talk about this. We got our base coat, we've got a micro metal flake, then we cleared it, multiple layers of clear at that. Then we wet sanded it with 1500. Then, yep, it keeps going, guys. Then these incredible SS stripes were laid down with another custom color. Then, I got to hand lay with very, very fine line tape these incredible flames in here. God, that was a lot of masking. Then we have multiple, actually we have four or five different, I'm trying to go back over the cycle now. Anyway, 4 to 5 different pearls in the custom flames, okay? Then, right, I'm not done yet. I feel like a sales guy for this. Then we actually did another round of metal flake over top, another trippin' flake. The first round of metal flake, was a micro metal flake from Little Daddy Roth. The second round of metal flake is called a trippin' metal flake from Little Daddy Roth. And it's called trippin' because it actually like flip-flops several different colors like a prism. That's just scattered and thrown kind of like over the whole car, over top of everything. But we didn't have time to wet sand it, guys, so the whole thing had like this crazy texture up in Michigan, and it still does. Because to do it right, I really want this thing to cure for about a week. Then we're gonna sand it back down, do about 3 to 4 more layers of clear, and then as you guys guessed it, more wet sanding. So after those additional layers of clear are on there, I'm actually gonna take 1500 to it, 2000, 3000, 5000, and guys, 8000 grit. And then we get to buff polisher, put all the chrome back on, the headlight bezels, some of the lights that still aren't there, and oh yeah, the rest of the interior. So you guys know what's under the hood, right? This started off as a small block. Actually, technically, I don't know if somebody wants me to tell you this, the car originally started off as a V6. When we got it, already had a small block in it. We got a big block transplant. There was a beautiful BoxPerformance motor in there. Now, it's not a full out done horsepower motor. It does got a little kick to it though. But that was done by my friends at BoxPerformance, who are also one of my sponsors. And I also want to give a special shout out to R&B Customs, who helped pay for that incredibly beautiful motor in there too, is one of my sponsors. Guys, while I'm thinking about it, thank you Kevin Hill with Schaefer Lubricants for my safety gear as well. Okay, safety gear, right? I'm not running like 6 seconds. Why do I have safety gear? Let's talk about that. I grew up at a racetrack. I've grown up around cars. My husband's the captain of a fire department, and he's the safety director at Dragway 42. I've seen a lot of stuff go down, guys. Whether you're in a 13-second car, a 10-second car, or a 6-second car, you never know what the guy or gal in the next lane is going through or happening. Murphy's Law likes to take place. Well, and let's face it, fire's fire, and a burn's a burn. Well, I like my tattoos and skin, so make fun of me all you want, some of you guys out there, but I'm gonna wear my full fire suit in this car because you never know what can happen. We hope nothing ever happens, but I'm not the prettiest thing, but you know, I still like my face and my skin. Okay, anyway, guys, so you're gonna see me racing that this year. So it is the street strip car. Actually, it'll be in Rockin' Race. Less than 2 weeks, guys, Rockin' Race. Like vintage nostalgia, drag racing, gassers, wheelie competition, music, pinups, flag girls, oh my gosh. It is my favorite event of the year, and I will be up there doing so much, so much. Like, there's so much I can't even talk about it because I can't remember it that much. Anyway, all right, guys, do you know what this is? I know some of you know, some of you are probably drooling. I'm drooling, can you see it? This is a actual, hear that? Steel body, Henry Ford, 1932 five window coupe. Now, this baby came in already having some previous work done that the client wasn't happy with, so we are going to redo the work now. Out by previous work, it wasn't us, we didn't do that. So somebody did some type of butt welding on here and some other things that you can get away with, but it's not our caliber. So we are gonna make this beauty perfect. I'm so excited. So the client hasn't decided on a couple things, whether he's gonna do a Mustang 2 front end or if he's gonna go with a traditional straight axle. He also hasn't decided, since there was previous work done up here, if we wanna stay with the metal roof or perhaps we wanna take this out and put the original wood back in there that gives us our 1.5-inch to 2-inch bend and then the cloth with all of our push buttons on there. So you know what, we'll see, but you guys gotta stay tuned for that build because, well, it's awesome, it's a 32.5 window, right? Okay. Whew. Guys, it is so muggy here in Ohio today, in Ashland, Ohio. Like, the glistening you see is not, it's sweat, okay? It's just sweat. All right, so, 1941 Ford behind me. So, gentleman brought this in to me, very meticulous. Sounds like it's been in the family since his grandfather. So, of course, we want to treat it right. Had a battery kind of explode underneath the hood is what the client had, and it left a little damage. So what we're doing is we're taking his engine bay, making sure it's all cleaned up. We actually had to take the battery tray out of it, do a little bit of sandblasting to it, repaint it, and it looks absolutely great in there. And now Emily, now normally guys, I need to be pretty specific. We're not a detail shop, but every once in a while you get a client who has a very gorgeous piece of American automotive history, and they don't just want to trust it to just anybody. So the people who happen to specialize in classic and antique automotive machinery sometimes get that. So we are giving this one like an extremely meticulous detail inside and out. And so I'm going over some stuff with Emily. She's probably like, what? We have to use Q-tips? That's the level we're getting, guys. But you know what? Wow. Can I just say, wow, this is a phenomenal ride. So we'll just leave it at that. I'm humbled to have it in here in my shop to see something in this type of condition. Makes my heart pitter-patter, and well guys, look at that. So Emily is over there doing a heck of a job, or as some of you guys hear me talk about her, Miss Mopar Mobley, because she does love her Mopars. Speaking of Mopars, so like guys, Roadkill, we were all at Roadkill, and I'm pretty sure she was in heaven. Being a Mopar gal, there was just Dodges all around, so she was just excited about that. We got to do so much. So they have thrill rides at Roadkill. So us ladies might have some video footage of us going very, very fast in a drift course. Like we actually have exterior view and we put a camera on selfie mode and you guys can watch us all rotate side to side for the drift course. And we did a high speed chase course as well, which was absolutely phenomenal, guys. Roadkill Nights up in Michigan is, it's incredible. Let's face it, they have stunt motorcycles up there. They have drag racing on Woodward Avenue, which we will be up there for that next year. And again, the car show this year was the Tom Bailey pre-party. I have so many incredible images and videos. I got to meet great people. And you know what's really humbling is when you have people that come up to you clear up in Michigan and they're fans of you in your shop and they want to pull you aside and say, hey, I follow you guys. I'm a huge fan. Let me tell you, we're there to see the people that we follow and love. So when those same people know who we are and other people find us because they're a fan, I want to say thank you, because the machinery is what keeps us going, the history. But guys, some days we have days that we just don't feel like we can do it. And you coming to us and talking about the quality that we're doing and how you love our work and have sometimes never seen anything that high quality, thank you. Just thank you so much. Okay, so, enough of that. I'm gonna be popping up videos and all sorts of stuff during this feed. All right, guys, there's the 67 Corvette, the very next rotisserie build. It's almost ready to take off that frame. We are almost there. Now, another thing we're working on, again, it is so muggy and hot in here. So, this is the Colonial Painting van. Now, Colonial Painting is a local painting company here in Ashland, Ohio. And they've used our services several times for auto body repair, some custom work too, and rust repair. We're actually taking off the old wrap on this, and Cheyenne's been doing a lot of repairs around the windshield. Matter of fact, the windshield's even all the way out. She just got that into primer, and whoo, there you go, that setting. But she does great fabrication, and I'm so proud of her. You guys hear me talk about Cheyenne all the time. So, you know, just keep following our page and watching the cool stuff that we do here. Okay, guys, I'm really excited about this. I know I keep moving the camera. Rob and I, especially Rob, really not me, I've been too busy. Rob has been working on this travel all behind us. You've been following the pictures, you've been following the posts and the videos. This 1972 International Travel Rat now has its three rows custom seating, the floors, and he's still working on it. We are gonna put an air ride system on it, slam it down to the ground. This winter, rear suicide doors are going on, and guys, it's getting made into a flame-throwing machine, like 50, 60-foot flames coming out the back of that. Can you, I can't wait, oh my gosh. All right, we're gonna keep it bare metal, excuse me. I actually ordered clear for it because I wanna do like some crushed glass or some really different metal flake that you don't always see on that. Whew. Okay, I almost forgot. There is so much coming up. Like, not only are we busy, we are actually still scheduling for fall and winter months because that's our busiest time, guys. So I still have December, January, and February open. So get a hold of me now if you can, because guys, we are definitely booking up for those winter months. Some events coming up, don't forget, less than 2 weeks away is Rockin' Race. I know I'm always talking about it, guys. It's the best show out there, though. You know it. It's at Dragway 42, August 23rd, 24th, 25th. Don Moyer is going to be out there. You know what that means, right? That means gassers. That means wheelie competitions. Oh, yeah, I might be helping head up the Flagrant Pinup Contest. I've got to see all the pinups. You guys haven't, but stay tuned because the next couple days, I'm gonna be posting up an album with all the beautiful ladies that are gonna be part of the most epic pinup contest that Rockin' Race has ever seen. Whew. Okay, guys, it's all about that, like Dragway 42 Rockin' Race. Oh my gosh, like, did you just hear that in my voice? Okay, there's some other shows coming up too, so I'm gonna make sure I get some pictures, snaps of those. I'm gonna put them up here for you because one is in September and it is a creepy Halloween type theme. Well, it's not really Halloween. Oh, it's totally Halloween, let's face it. It's a Rat Rod and Hearst show. And you guys know I like might have a bat on my chest, a giant skull on my back, some spider webs somewhere. And if you've ever seen my one leg, well, I've got Lily Munster, Elvira, and Morticia Adams because I am the creepy chick. Anyway, guys, there are so many shows coming up. And Kandi's is really proud to announce again that this year we are going to help sponsor and host up the second annual cruise-in at the Hayesville Vermilion Fire Department, October 12th. Guys, that's October 12th. It is a special trunk or treat cruise-in, so definitely mark your calendars for that. I will have flyers by next week at the absolute latest, okay? I'm losing my voice, guys. That's just how it's been. I want to thank everybody for tuning in. I want to give a big special shout out to Matrix and House of Color because, guys, House of Color is going to be in here before we know it. We are going to be hooking up with them to have an in-house public tutorial clinic. Can you guys believe that? Like, Kandi's Customs and House of Color. Oh, my gosh. Okay. Hayesville Fire Department, October 12th. Okay. Cruise in. All right, guys. Kandi Blaze. Kandi's Roth and Customs. I got to go. See you guys around. Bye.